If life is abundant in the universe, then it must exist and thrive in some of the most exotic environments, as it does on Earth. To get a full picture of this, we will cover both traditional and non-traditional forms of life that might be possible in these extreme environments. We will cover life that might exist on exotic planets, in burning stars, and in space. More traditional forms of life may be found on the planets of the universe. Cellular life is known to adapt to the harshest environments on Earth, so it has likely taken hold in many other planetary environments as well. One of the more interesting environments that could support complex life might be the Methane World, one well-known body in our solar system that is an example of such an environment would be the Saturnian moon of Titan. These worlds are much like Earth in that they have a functional hydrosphere with rain, lakes, rivers, and clouds. The molecule that makes up this hydrosphere is methane, instead of water, which is composed of four hydrogen molecules and a carbon molecule. These planets are much colder than the Earth, and liquid methane can only exist at these very low temperatures. It has been theorized that life could exist on one of these worlds, as methane is a good solvent. In fact, it could be even better than water for life as it contains four hydrogen molecules instead of two, allowing for more bonds. Some findings have suggested that basic life may indeed exist on the surface of Titan, but more research will have to be done. Another proposed form of life is one that uses silicon as the base element for life, instead of carbon. This life could potentially arise on silicon-rich worlds that don't have a lot of carbon. Silicon is able to have a lot of bonds and can form into large molecules, so it may be a good replacement for carbon in biochemistry. Silicon does have some drawbacks, however, and recent research has further discredited this theory. Strange forms of aerial life may even be possible in the upper atmosphere of some gas giants. On Earth, microbes have been found in the upper atmosphere, so it is highly likely that similar life forms would be found in some gas giants. Some gas giants may even be home to complex ecosystems of multicellular organisms. These planets would have to be at the right distance from their star, however, as a gas giant that is too hot or cold would likely not be able to sustain life. According to one theory, it is possible that an extremely exotic form of life may evolve and replicate within stars. It is thought that two types of theoretical structures, strings and monopoles, may be able to come together to form repeating patterns in the interior of a star, similar to how atoms and molecules came together to form RNA and DNA on Earth. It has even been theorized that these structures could come together to form two- and three-dimensional objects. According to scientists, this form of life could evolve to become very complex and intelligent. It is likely that such beings would have a completely different perspective and understanding of the universe, compared to us. After all, they wouldn't even be made of the same elementary building blocks that we are. Complex life in space is unlikely, but it is possible that very simple forms of life cling to existence in very special cases. Bacteria have been found to survive even in ice and permafrost for hundreds of thousands of years, so it is possible that some of the asteroids and meteoroids drifting around in space have bacteria or spores frozen in them. There is even a theory called panspermia that actually says that life on Earth was seeded here from one of these microbe-containing space rocks. Other than microbes, it has been suggested in simulations that dust surrounded by plasma in space may be able to come together to form DNA-like helix structures, but more research is needed on this. It is also possible that life exists in higher and lower dimensions. Many theories in physics add many more dimensions, and some exotic forms of life may flourish inside these dimensions. These beings would certainly be much different from us, and might not even be able to interact with us or our world. These beings might also be interdimensional, and may be able to move in between or through dimensions, but this is just speculation. As further research moves toward a unified theory of everything, we will likely gain a better understanding of other dimensions. Only time will tell. Thank you for watching. If you're new to the channel, be sure to stick around and subscribe for lots of more content. We'll see you all in the next video.